Hello, I'm Joanne Ingberg. And before I begin my presentation, I will preface it this way. Pretty soon, the Dodgers will be playing in the World Series. You're in the ninth inning. Score is tied. Your TV is off. Are you happy about this? No. So what are you going to do? You're going to call and call. What is going on with my game? Well, I feel exactly the same way. I'm discussing water, lights, primarily lights. I live on Glendower between Alexander and Hillings. If you're not familiar with Glendower, consider the Arkansas Station. That's Glendower. We had a meeting not very long ago where we counted the votes. Our section of Glendower, all the way to Haven, voted yes. The other half of Glendower, all the way to Roxbury, voted no. So, this means this 1, 2, 3 lights are going to go out. We on this west side of Glendower, 1, 2, 3, are going to be paying for these lights. But we right here on the west side of Glendower are not. We will be paying property taxes on 1, 2, 3 lights, not the lights here. Would you like to be in that situation, paying up $100 a year or more on your property taxes? Then it will go up to 125. Property taxes never go down. I think it's unfair. I think it's unjust. I contacted Mr. Glennon. We also called Mr. Smith, but we must have missed your call when you called us back. So I would like this to be taken care of. To me, there's no excuse for us to have to pay for something that we're not receiving.
Ron?
Yes, ma'am. I agree with you 100%. It's unjust, and it's unfair, and it's wrong. So that's why we fix it. So those three lights that are on the east side of Glendower, even though they're in the other assessment district, all the street lights there, and also Hillcrest, there's 10 homes on Hillcrest that get that one light on the north side of the northeast corner of Glendower.
Right,
all
right
the
here.
There, there's 10 homes there. There's
right.
About 17 homes down on the east side of, well, I guess it would be the west side, facing east of Glendower. Those homes there. Right.
These on Hillcrest.
Right, and there's 10 homes there and 17 homes that are in your section that were used to, that will not have any street lights if we turn those off. Those
exactly.
Those three street lights will not be turned off.
Okay, so you are assuring me and my neighbors that these three lights will stay on.
Correct. There was another district also that I actually drove up there personally 3 times and took the numbers on the pole. You know, if there's a glitch and one of them goes out because Rock here is working on the engineering report. We went through there. There was another one. I apologize. That's something that we, depended on the engineer that we hired to do this because they're the experts. But then I think it was are you the one that was right across from that little street light?
I sure am.
Okay, so I got the phone call and I drove out there and I checked it out and then I agreed that no, those should stay on. There's one other neighborhood. What is it? Oak?
20th Street West.
20th Street Oak, and then what's the next street down?
Oak and Elm.
And they have two lights that would be turned off, but it takes care of that whole neighborhood. That's just unfair. So those street lights will stay.
Okay.
If they turn off, you better call me because then we gotta go make sure they. But we're telling Edison not to turn those lights on.
Are you considering them arterial lighting, are we?
No, there's not interior lights. They're all part of LL82.
Oh, okay.
They're in that assessments district, but they provide the benefit for the people that are going to be paying, like you said, they're going to be paying taxes and having those street lights at all because they happen to be on the other side. What the engineer probably should have done is incorporated your neighborhood, that neighborhood, the small one to the south, and Hillcrest to the north, and made it one big unit to keep all of the lights on.
Yeah,
right.
What happened was this was built in the 50s, like 55.
Right.
and this one over here was built in 60.
Right, so it's two different tracks, but I think in hindsight, the engineer should have lumped them together, but we're fixing it so those three lights will stay on.
Okay, and again, you can tell, if those lights don't stay on, I will be...
The Dodgers will lose.
No, they're going to lose.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Any other problem?
Williford Park over there. I know we don't have the funds to keep the park up, but you got to do something with that playground area. You got to do something with that cement for somebody gets hurt tripping. You got to get the weeds out of the sand. It's real simple. It has to be done. And the same thing here, there's a piece of grass I saw last week when I was in here. Look at these walls around here, pins all over. I mean, and look at Mr. Smith's picture. It's crooked on the wall. I mean, you guys...
I'll have that taken care of right away.
You guys, we have a secretary, don't we? But anyway, you're going to run this place just like a park? All I ask for the park is to get the weeds out of the sand. Just the kids can play.
We're looking at the cement thing right now there, and we're getting estimates on...
Cement's a big thing, but the weeds got to get out of the sand for the kids to play. It looks terrible. And I don't think none of you five been down there.
Not true.
Have you been down there and seen it?
Of course.
Because I walk my dog all the time, I don't see none of you. But I sure see this gentleman down there. He's down there asking questions about it. So, just get the weeds out of the sand, please.
Thing that we need to do, remember it's not, it's a guide of what's going on in the district, but it's not our strategic plan, which is one of the things that we want to work on in the future. This is sort of just a guide of what we're actually, you know, been looking forward, and we have to submit this in order to get grants. So it's a basic template, but as we go through the next year and create a strategic plan, that's going to be more of a guiding document of how we move forward. And there are a few things that need to be tweaked on it, but after tonight, we can still tweak it before we submit.
It would be appropriate to open the public hearing.
Okay, because it's further down on the list. Well, we'll open public hearing this time.
Opening up the public hearing, I just want to provide a brief overview on the plan itself, the purpose of the plan. The Department of Water Resources of California requires that these plans be put in place, which evaluate the district's water supply portfolio, looking forward, looking at the water supply options that are available to the district today, and looking forward 25 to 30 years into the future as to how those water supplies will help to meet your demands of the future. So our plan, which we developed, the 2010 Urban Water Management Plan, was approved by DWR. We took that plan as the baseline for the 2015 and just updated based on what we know with respect to your availability of supplies, the adjudication decision, and how that affects and impacts your future water supply portfolio. So the Urban Water Management Plan takes all those measures into account, looks at your population base and how that increases over the course of the next 30 years, and matches those two items, your population and your supply, and then identifies either deficits or surpluses in your balance for your water supply portfolio. So today we'd like to open up the public hearing on that document, which was made available to the public, and open it up for public comment.
I thought we already opened it.
Okay, what were you saying?
Director, do you want directors go first, or public go on?
You can take public comment first.
Public comments regarding this.
On this survey, we keep talking about more water, sewer. How's that affect all these new homes being built? Just now, on the way down here, you go straight down 35th, dead end, all the way down to the end. Looks like you're getting ready to build homes. There's water all over spraying down that dirt.
Can you want your general manager to tell you how that affects that? Go ahead, Ron.
Yeah, the Urban Water Management Plan is about our water supply and everything, which the adjudication really affects it. If you have people that are wasting water, call our agency and we'll check into it.
Well, how does this come with new homes and new tracks coming up?
Well, the new homes and the new tracks is there is a water acquisition program throughout the whole valley, and we have one also. We cannot give out a will serve letter for new homes to be produced unless they can help us acquire water rights for them, which is pumping rights or purchasing water through the state water project. So they have to pay a fee, and it's not, and that water does not affect the rest of the residents, except in the extent that they probably will not use as much water as we have to acquire. So it does help us a little bit on pumping rights. We just got done purchasing 150 acre feet of water rights, and we sold, or actually give will serve letters because they paid a fee for it, for 940 acre feet of those, for the 94 homes that Legacy is going to build. So that's the only way out in this whole valley, because of the water adjudication by the judge, is that you either have to get pumping rights or you have to buy from AVAC. AVAC is more expensive and doesn't really help us as much, because if we have the pumping rights, that gives us the right to pump the water. We can do it cheaper for the public, and so that's why we went for the pumping rights rather than them paying maybe $12,000 to $15,000 an acre foot to go through AVAC to purchase what's called Table A water.
Correct. And to add to that, to Ron's comment, sir, the actual plan itself has a chapter within the plan that's called demand management measures that serves as a process and a guideline for the district and for the public. For any time that there's an application of water that's not in conjunction with the California Urban Water Conservation Council, or there's overuse of water, for example, breaks, main breaks or leaks, the district has a plan in place to mitigate against that. So there's a chapter within the plan itself that's demand management measures, of which they will be on point to look through all of those demand management measures to ensure that those are not being violated in the area. And there's also a water shortage contingency plan within the document that evaluates all unapproved water uses within the district.
But my leaks and that's one thing. Why keep building new homes when we can save the water for all of us here now? Why more street lights, electricity, when we can save what we have now?
The building of the new homes will not exist but for them actually being able to obtain water rights. It doesn't affect these water rights. And in fact, I've actually made it so it benefits us. So the 150 acre feet that we bought for about $975,000, and I sold $940,000 with it. And we still have 54 acre feet left, or 56 acre feet left. So that's water that we can pump for our citizens, or we can sell it to get money to actually go out and purchase more water rights. But for the developer's money, they wouldn't be building.
So water right now that's running out there, where they're going to be building those homes, is okay. That's not affecting.
No, that's another subject. That's apples and oranges. If there's water being ran where it shouldn't be, then we need to go out there and check it. If you tell John.
They have acquired the water right to do that. They have come in here and they paid this agency, already bought the water, not water that Rosamond uses. They came in and bought their own, they bought water rights to build those housing tracts. So any tract that comes into this area from here on out has to bring their own water.
And what that does, it allows us to pump more water.
And when I say bring their own water, they come to us, they give us the money, we go out and find the water.
They can't pump it.
Okay, so the pump over here down for the junior high, I see these trucks fill up all the time. Then they have water trucks go down these streets. Mm-hmm. That's the water they're buying from that pump over there?
You're talking about the school?
Uh-huh, right down from the school where the crossing guard is. I see a water truck come right in there and fill up. And I see them come down these tracks and they're spreading water across the tracks as the people are working.
So you're talking construction water?
Construction water.
Right, so they're purchasing that construction water separately. They're buying separately.
Oh,
construction
okay.
Water is different.
Okay. But they don't have no time period like we do, not the water, but certain times in the evening. Why is it going on at 2-3 o'clock in the afternoon?
They have to comply.
But they bought theirs, I understand.
They have to comply with AQMD for air quality also.
Okay.
Yeah, you have competing agencies that AQMD and the water boards all competing.
And added note, is it true, John, the water level come up?
In our wells, they've come up, yes.
How much?
I don't know exactly, but I would guess at least a foot.
At least a foot. Mm-hmm. Major questions. Here, I don't agree that we should keep passing anything as a draft. It was said that this is made available to the public. I know that we didn't get it until Friday at Labor Day weekend. I don't think that counts as good as this.
We provided the district a copy of that in June 2016.
Okay, that's what was made available to the public was in. Friday.
And it was
Friday.
It was put out there publicly. How many days ago?
30 days. 60 days notification to neighboring agencies and 30
and
days.
And it went to neighboring agencies too to look at it.
When was that actually posted on the website here?
When was that?
Or was it ever?
Yes, it was uploaded to the website as well.
It was more than 30 days ago. Mm-hmm. It was the start of August.
And then, but I'm looking at it, so I went ahead and printed what was sent to me. It says draft. And what you're asking is for to do after public hearing, that is a draft?
Draft final is basically, it will remain draft until it's approved and until all comments and questions are consolidated, which is what will stem from this public hearing. If there's any comments that would result in any changes to the plan, we would reconcile those and then call it final.
Well, right. Start, for example, on page 22 and page 23, it says, and thank you for putting it there, you put in a number of comments on the side, and great, hopefully the public also has access to those comments. Comment AR2, what is the effective date for the adjudication? Adjudication becomes effective blank. That's a good question. Adjudication became effective, I think, when the appeal ended, is that right?
It became effective on December 23rd, 2015. The appeal might affect it, but as of today, it's effective December 23rd, so we can...
That's okay, and the other part is, the next page, although the groundwater basin is not currently adjudicated, that obviously is an incorrect statement. Adjudication process is nearing implementation. Since the basin is not adjudicated, has not been deemed an overdraft by DWR, there are currently no existing restrictions on pumping.
Right, and we found several of those as staff reviewing the document over this period of time, and those things will be fixed before we upload it to the DWR.
In addition, this is a working document, so it's still considered a working file. There may be strike and delete comments that you might not be able to see there, but those comments obviously are not applicable to the district. The other thing that I want to add is, once you've completed your review and we stamp it final here, it's not considered final until DWR has reviewed and approved that document. So it's going to go through two levels of review once we're complete here. DWR, once they've completed their review, they will issue a letter to the district saying they approve and stamp approve this document for you to receive any further grant funding from any source, whether it be federal or state. So that document needs to be in place and approved by DWR for you to continue to receive grant funds. So the review period does not end here. It's finalized by DWR's review.
Right, and the reason why we're pushing it through like this, there's a few things that we have to fix, and that's a major thing, is that, you know, we are not only applying for arsenic consolidation construction money, we're asking for chromium money, we're asking for all these grants, and we're not going to be eligible for those grants if this document is not in place.
Well, let's go through what it says about that. It says the, as far as page 25, comment AR4, is it true that the annual intake and return capacities are 10,000 acre feet per year on the ground, on the water bank? And then it says, it is anticipated with one new well, with an 800 to 1,000 gallon per minute capacities planned to become online in the near future. Is it, what comment, did this happen? Is it still planned?
So there's comments that are lingering there, Director. The district staff can also approve and provide comment on that so that we can take that information and update the draft itself.
Well, here's the one about the grant fund. It says, in addition, Antelope Valley Region, and this is 6.4 stormwater, and this is a big one. In addition, the Antelope Valley Region, of which RCSD's department was awarded grant funds, Proposition 84 to update the ABIRWMP to include a regional flood management plan. And the comment is, as it's been used. And the recent regional flood management plan is, I think, Mr. Smith first found as the director here, or not director, as the general manager, first thing that happened is we had a big flood. And he had to go get his booster. They're driving his new
booster. That's because they were driving with you.
So. Yeah. Otherwise, he would have got stuck in. But the point is, I think I asked you earlier about this. Is this something we can present, for example, to the Rosa Municipal Advisory Council, which is a county organization here in town, that you present that thing?
We'd be happy to present that to them if requested by you. I don't have a problem presenting that. What I can do is I can have the slides summarizing each of the major points and the highlight points of the document to your audience.
You know, this way, we don't have the slides you can present to us tonight. But, okay, that's kind of weird, but okay.
Well, only because you're requesting for me to develop them. I'd be more than happy to develop them for the audience that you're requesting me to present to. I wasn't asked to develop slides for today's presentation.
And if they wanted to offer some input, that would still get into the final document?
If it's within the 30-day period, then yes.
Okay, so you could appear on the 15th of...
I can do that.
If you'd like to, we can continue this. I mean, we've reviewed it. We've done public notice and had a public hearing for public comments. We can continue continue to take public comments all the way up to the time that's drafted, so why don't you just continue it to the next meeting, and then we'll make some of these changes, any other changes that you find, give you more time to review it, and then bring it back to another public hearing.
Let's Dennis, Dennis, you have something to say?
Go ahead.
I like the gentleman's recommendation, continue it, come back, look at it, have a next meeting, give us more time to review.
Reopen. Okay, so we're not gonna reopen the public hearing?
No, my question is it the board's pleasure to reopen the public hearing and continue it, or to continue this matter for consideration?
We can continue to take public comments in writing or in person to change it, but we don't necessarily have to have another public hearing.
I just wanted to clarify what we would be continuing, if we're continuing consideration.
So if you want to continue it and take more public comment, then you have to reopen with a motion, reopen the public hearing, and then continue it. You could do that in one motion, correct?
Yes, or we can close the public hearing now and continue to receive comments on the draft.
Right, but they're saying if they want to have a public hearing again and have public comment at a meeting, then we have to reopen it. It's your pleasure. Either way, we're still gonna take public comments.
I'd like to see it continued so we have a chance to read it and get back from any of you.
Do you want to continue with the public hearing, or continue back for?
I think we had the public hearing.
Okay, that's fine.
And I just.
Because it was public notice.
More time to read it.
Correct. And then also make the changes. I mean, Bullock brought some changes, Brock has found some changes, I found some changes, and so we'll incorporate all those changes and bring back a cleaner document for you and give you time to review it, and we'll give you those changes as we go. So then you can just make a motion to continue.
I make a motion that we continue.
Consideration of adoption of resolution 2016-104.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Second. Ed made the motion, Ed second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All right, want to tell us about that?
Yes, we rewrote one position. It's not changing salaries or anything, but we thought it more clearly described what the job was. We have a person at the water bank that does water banking stuff rather than just water operator one, and so we re-described that so it better fits what the job does, and that's what we need to do once in a while. And it doesn't change the pay. The second one is that we had a position that did USAs and facility maintenance and did some stuff, as you know, with the budget. We got rid of paying outside services for janitorial, for car washing, so we rewrote that position to save money on the budget. It would be a person that doesn't do USAs, is not as well trained, but can do, you know, some of the maintenance and do oil changes and do car washes and do janitorial. And remember, on the budget, I think that saved us close to $60,000. And so so that's actually lowering the compensation. So what we need from you is the approval to approve those two job descriptions, and then also for the compensation.
You're including A on this?
Yeah.
Public comments? Director's comments?
No, I just like to take them separate.
You want to take them separate?
Yeah, one's a resolution, one's not.
Dennis?
No.
So the director then said you want to move item NB1A separate from item NB1B?
Yes, I'll do that separately. Move NB1A.
Just as a point of technicality, doesn't NB1B have to be adopted before you can even take a motion on NB1A? Because those positions don't even exist in a common class until there actually is a particular class.
Yes, so we would need to do NB1B first.
Okay.
Just technical.
I'll move we adopt resolution 2016-100.
Second.
Roll call.
Vice President
Lanza. Aye.
Director Schimmelbecker.
Yes.
Director Klein.
Yes.
Director McKay.
Yes.
President Wallace.
Yeah.
Now I move we approve the salary schedule for the facility maintenance worker and water bank operator.
Second.
This can be done by voice vote.
Do I have a second?
Not yet.
I'll second.
Ole made the motion, Ed seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
Yes.
Okay. Go to B now.
Yeah, Yes, Mr. President, on this resolution adopting a conflict of interest code, it updates our previous ones. As you know, the attorney can fill you in, things change as we go, and so this is a cleaner, updated version for the administrative code for conflict of interest.
It reflects changes to the FEPC regulations as well as some of the changes in the allocation of responsibility within district staff, and so it's more current than what we previously had, and make sure we're in full compliance with the FEPC regulations.
It looks like it's like follows closely Form 700.
It is for Form 700. It tells you who needs to do a Form 700 and which schedules they must fill out. That's what it is.
Public comment. Okay, it's roll call.
Motion.
Ed made a motion, did a second, roll call.
Vice President Lansbury?
Aye.
Dr. Schindelberger?
Yes.
Dr. Glennon?
Yes.
Dr. McKay?
Yes.
President Wallace?
Yes.
Yes.
We've gone through this quite a bit. We had, three meetings on the previous rate study and then several budget meetings. The board decided to not adopt the presented rate study before and said to go back and make budget adjustments and see if we could lower the rates. One of the also concerns was that the first three units, was being paid for with the commodity rate. And historically, those three units were incorporated within your base rate, and you get those first three units as having the water service. So we went through a lot of budget meetings and adopted a new fiscal budget. We went back and made those adjustments to what was presented to you, and then also found a way to incorporate the first three units into the base rate. And that was done by taking the actual cost of production and putting that into the base rate, and then taking the revenue loss from the sale of the commodity and putting that in the commodity rate. So overall, what you have is from, and I'm going to say first of what was presented. Just talking about the water, because that was a concern before with Mr. McKay and Mr. Schindelberger, the water alone for three HCFs, dropped what was presented and our rates today that we're presenting to you, which I'm calling the adjusted ones. We adjusted the rate study. Everything else on the rate study should stay the same, except we're incorporating the first three units, so people get that with their base rate. They don't have to pay for that. They're paying for it within the base rate. And also in lowering the rates. So that was a difference of, it's going down $7.36. If you're an average user of 15 HCFs, it's going down $3.76. Sewer is still going down. Three HCFs is going down an additional $1.08. So when I say this is going down, it's not from what the rates are now, but it's what was presented to you. And then the sewer total, 15, it's going down $1.08. The majority of everybody in this district has water and sewer together. So if you have water and sewer together, if you're using three HCFs, what we're presenting tonight compared to what we presented before is going down $8.44. We cut because you requested us to make it lower. 15 units is going down $4.84. So if you look at the price that it's going up rather than just what we cost, let's compare it to what everybody's paying now and what they would pay under these new adjusted rates. For somebody who uses three HCFs for their water and sewer, it's going up $7.72 per month. For somebody who's an average user, 15 HCFs, it's going up $7.60. So the rate study that was presented before, all the engineering, all the other math, is all the same. But remember, this study now doesn't give, I don't want to say it's free, but you don't pay on your bill extra for the three HCFs. You get that with your base rate. So if you don't use any more than three HCFs, that's what you get with your base rate. And it only kicks in when you go to the fourth unit, and then you have to start paying the rate, which is actually, the new rate is actually lower than the rate that we're paying now. We're paying $2.24. This would be $2.13.
Public comments.
Who has water and sewer together in here? You have water and sewer? Where do you live? I get a.
Most people do.
Unless you don't have sewers.
If you're running water and have a septic tank, then that would be different. You know, I think.
Yeah, I gotta look at my bill. It's together. I kind of look at it separate.
No, you're in it together.
We did lose sewer for a while.
Okay, I gotta go look at my bill. I'm thinking water, sewer together.
Rules, we're voting for is a rate study. Last time I voted to approve the rate study because my understanding was, doesn't necessarily mean I agree with it. I don't have to agree with what the tier structure is. I don't have to agree with what the recommended cost of starting out is at this point. But if I want to, if we want to, at the 60 days from now, whenever we look at this again, on November 1st, if we want to say, well, I don't want to start the rate out at $32 or $33, I want to start it out at $30 on the water, we can do that. Is that right?
You can do a lower number than what we noticed. You cannot do a higher number.
There's ramifications for that, and we discussed that stepping in, and that's where the last board got in trouble, because they did that step. You will still bleed money for the first couple of years. You are going to have a large jump as you go there, because you have to, it's not like you just stair-step up to where you are, because every year that you're stair-stepping up, you're losing more money that has to be recouped within that rate study. So the graph, if this is the level, if you have to go from point A, stair-step, and you get here, this whole section here, you've lost money, millions of dollars. You have to recoup that. So the line doesn't go to this point, it goes above, and then comes down.
All I'm saying is we could come to the line if we want to, plus the facts change. Lorena, the facts change, and we can also have lower numbers, is that right?
Well, you can ask me, she's not the rate study person. So, but if we get water rights, pumping rights, if we're able to get Table A water cheaper, if whatever it is that works out for us in the future, if we don't have to buy AVAC water completely, yes, you can always lower the rates. But at this point, this is based on what the actual is, what we're doing now, based on in the next 5 years, we have to ramp down to buy AVAC water, that we have to do chromium. We might find a better way to do chromium. We might use some scrubbers, but we might have to blend. So,
Here's the point.
2-3 years from now, you can always say, you know what? When we look at the actuals every year, 2-3 years from now, we can say, you know what? We're doing good. We have enough of the stability fund. I mean, this doesn't even cover the stability funds that we need in your administration handbook.
Well, 2-3 years
from now. You can always lower the rates later.
Well, 2-3 months from now, we're going to know, I guess, one of the variables that we've been waiting on for so long is, what is the water engineer at Lavelli, the water master, going to say? For example, with tertiary water, my understanding is already written in the document that tertiary water, we do get credit for the return flows.
Yeah, it's not in the document.
And if it isn't in the document, the water engineer can address that almost right off the top.
This is getting into water adjudication. As I said before, that document, the water master is not deciding facts and not deciding changing the document. They're supposed to implement. Everything's going to go back to that judge if it's not implemented properly. And if the judge already made a decision, we're still trying to figure out, there's other ways to try to get return flow, but we're trying to think of creative ways. But as of right now, if the language isn't there, the water master can't change the language of the document.
I saw it when I went to the meeting. It was right there in the
room. You have to show me. I haven't read it. It's all imported water. Yeah. You get return flow on imported water.
Well,
we can talk about the water engineer.
It can be addressed by the water engineer, and they can lower the actual true cost of a tertiary water that we're producing. And I posed a question, and they had it on the agenda, but they took it off because obviously premature. But the question still remains, and Mr. Joyce didn't seem to like that, but if we wanted to raise money, I don't think we'd have to raise money to put in a tertiary distribution system that went out, say, as far as 210th Street West. That at a cost of $4 million, that would be, what, about $4 per month on a tax bill, I think.
I think that's a great subject for the strategic plan meetings and workshops, because we have to figure out where we're going and what are our priorities.
You can probably do the same thing with purchasing the appropriate water in perpetuity, 2,000 acre feet, all over short. The point is,
correct.
Once we do that, can we use that as a selling point to say, look, once we do that, we're going to lower your water rates, because now we've got your commodity rates covered.
If we can produce water at $100 an acre foot rather than $500 an acre foot, it would behoove us to reconsider the rate. And this rate study is going to be done in 5 years anyway. The ramp down's going to be finished by then. Okay, we're going to start the ramp down in 1 year and 1 year and 4 months now is when the ramp down starts.
Right. The first part of the ramp. And the question, of course, related to that is, if the ramp down doesn't start in 2017, why do we have tiered rates? Isn't every single gallon we produce here produced at $9 an acre foot by public?
Okay. The tiered rate is there because also, as we were told tonight, the state still has, we have mandates because of the drought and fines and things, and so we have to calculate everything that's going to go in perpetuity. But this is also to build up the stability fund so we can actually manage that for a longer period of time. We have no stability fund to pay for everything. So that setting the rates now the way they are will build a stability fund that when the cost of water goes higher as it keeps on going, that stability fund, remember on the chart, it will pay for that overage. So when water starts costing $700, $800 an acre foot, we'll have money in the reserve to pay for that over the 5 years. Remember, it's this whole rate is calculated for a 5 year period. That doesn't mean you can't revisit it in 3 years when we actually, see if the, like we said.
We revisit it in 6 months, we gotta change.
Bolt House might decide they're gonna bolt, and they might leave. And then guess what, they have a lot of water. And there's a lot of people that are gonna buy it up, and a lot cheaper. And if we can get water rights, to me, that's the best. That's what's going to be the best for this agency, is if we can get the water rights to do that. Right now, everybody's tied to the plan, and they're not going to give up any water. Because the water master's still going through. So we have a couple of years to figure that out.
And another question on adjusting, for example, the meter sizes. Feeling compound, 6-inch meter, they're paying $249 base rate every month. Out of this rate, it increases to $800 a month?
Yeah, John was supposed to be working with them to get the meters that they really need, to get different meters so they're not paying for the larger meters. And I think that, do they contact you finally?
I've talked to the lady up there. We're going to go up there and do a field visit.
They're going to go do a field visit.
If they don't need a hydrant on their property, then there's no reason to have a 6-inch meter.
Right, and the 6-inch meters are expensive, and so they're going to see if they can fix something else, and so it's cheaper.
Okay, but the numbers still jump dramatically. I mean, it's one thing to jump from $20 to $33 for a homeowner. If you're jumping from $250 to three times that for anybody else, why the variation? Why are they jumping so high?
Well, I think that was explained last time when the other person was here that did the rate study. We don't have them here tonight because those questions, I thought, were all
answered. That's not a DEI question.
It's not this GEI. There's a lot of engineers in GEI, and this is not the water rate study GEI.
I swear it green goes. We need to keep
They're paying for the capacity to pump that if they needed to.
Right, yes.
That's what they're paying for.
Yeah, and the difference between 1 inch and 6 inch is quite a bit.
Sound like you and the general manager.
Well, yeah, as long as we have
this,
this board has a chance to discuss it, to adjust it on November 1st if you want as well.
You can adjust downward,
right,
but not upward.
Okay.
Dennis, I have a clarification.
Okay.
And the Water Master Board is waiting to hire a Water Master Engineer to write all the requirements that the board has to meet.
Correct.
The Water Master Engineer is going to look at the document that the judge put out, and he's going to tell the board then how it can be accomplished.
He or she is going to write the operating rules.
Yes.
Okay, and not change, it's not going to change the judgment. And then plus, as you know, because you're at the meeting, that engineer's not going to be hired until they get an advisory committee in place, and that's going to be huge because you have, I think within the Woods class or something like that, there's 4,000, pumpers. All of those have to be considered who is in that advisory committee. So right now the Water Master is going through all the pumpers are going through the process of creating, how are they going to create the advisory committee? That advisory committee is the one that has to help pick the engineer. And then once the engineer is placed, then they got to have the rules. So it's
laborious. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe that, didn't they say that there's a going to be nine members to that advisory committee?
No, they haven't decided what it's going to be yet. They're going to get together. They're trying to do it like they did the farmers or the landowners, is the water master is sort of going to be the facilitator, and at the last meeting, they said they're going to notify the attorneys in court. So all the attorneys can notify their clients, because on one class, like I said, there's 4,000 litigants in one class. So instead of the water master and us incurring all the costs, they figured they'll do one notification through court to the attorneys. The attorneys can notify them. They'll have a massive meeting. In fact, Rob Harris said, we need to, maybe get Jethawk Stadium or something. All the people are coming to have that first meeting for everyone to show. And at that meeting, it's going to be decided, can they create a steering committee out of all those people, of maybe just a handful of people, to try to work on the rules to actually create the advisory committee. And it's, once we get past a couple of these, this main advisory committee and the engineer, everything's going to go a lot faster with the water master, but it's, everybody's vying for position right now, is what's happening.
Okay, are we going to main discussions?
Could.
You want to take them separately?
Yeah, that's fine.
So we're on B.
You're on A, to accept the rate study.
A discussion action.
So move.
Mr. Glennon makes a motion to accept it. Dennis seconds it. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
No.
4-1, Director Lyons, are voting no.
We have 4-3-2, Mr. McKay and Mr. Lyons are voting no.
I'm sorry, I did not hear you, Mr. McKay.
Discussion and action to set a public hearing for over 1st at 7 o'clock. Any public comments?
You had public comments for the whole thing, so you can just go over.
Oh, but well, if anybody can ask for it. But basically, this has got to be set for that date, is that correct?
Correct. We have to mail it out, we have to set a date, and we have to bring it back.
So I'll move. Second?
I'll second it for discussion purposes.
Mr. Glennon makes a motion. Mr. Glennon starts. Seconds it. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
Yes.
Any and all other actions required for the notice and hearing? That includes publication in both papers.
My understanding was the motion was item C as listed on the agenda.
Yes. Mr. Glennon made the motion in a second.
And that includes publication in both papers.
Can you comment on that, General Manager?
That's not before the board. Yeah.
That is consistent required by law for the notice and hearing.
And my take is that's the general manager's responsibility.
That's not a specific action item that you can vote on tonight, on which papers you're going to publish them.
Okay.
All in favor?
We did not give the.
Aye.
Yeah, we had a motion and a second.
No, but we hadn't voted yet. Oh. And you just did, and it was unanimous.
All right, director's reports, comments, future agenda items. 6 and 7 meeting. And one of the things that we were discussing up there was the agriculture initiative. One of the things that we don't believe that the state is really looking at is the amount of water that ag needs to produce the food. And so ACWA is looking into that. And also there was a discussion there about the Little Hoover Commission that was meeting after our meeting to discuss special districts. And then I also attended the last water master meeting, and it was a smooth meeting. They have selected the 5 directors, and they have a full board now, and they're trying to get together to hire a water master engineer to set the rules for them.
Just if I could add that they had a special meeting also, it was an additional meeting. And at that meeting, they were putting out to get some RFQs from some what you call headhunter agencies to look for an engineer, and then they're going through the process of how are they going to notify all of the pumpers so they can do so. They called a special meeting for that one. So that's the added step.
Any other directors' comments?
Yes, so just briefly. Rosamond Supervisor Council will be meeting on the 15th of September. The speaker will be from GEI, Ms. Lorena, presenting on the urban water use plan. And she's agreed to do that tonight. We were going to have a debate between Steve Fox and Tom Lackey. We figured Lorena would be much better. Apparently, Tom Lackey couldn't make it, so Lorena, we're happy to have you fill in. And I will double check to make sure that our chairman, Mr. Schaffer, is good with that. No problems with that. We should be our speaker.
Oh, are you through, Lorena?
Well, not through.
Okay. Go ahead, go ahead.
Okay. Just a quick report. Congratulations to the Rosamond High School football team. I'd like to thank Rowan. And for those of you who don't know, we played Lancaster High School last week. The final score is Rosamond 37, Lancaster 30. And my new favorite quote comes out of the Elm Valley Press from Rosamond tailback, Tayshawn Claiborne. It sounds a lot like Ron Smith, so hopefully Ron will be able to send Mr. Claiborne's quote to maybe the mayor of Lancaster. I think it would be a good PR move. Let's see if he's got the big brass ones to do that. What do you think?
I don't know what the direction was on that one. I'll let you call Ron.
I'll get you the quote. You can see whether you want to send. But anyway, appreciate the good job everybody's doing here.
Yeah. Yes. One of the things I was remiss, Mr. Smith, when we were talking about the consent agenda, I had failed to bring up an item on the Intellicom situation. I see we're still paying them $300 for every one of our connections. And I believe that the going rate is about $1,500 an antenna that they have up on top of our tanks, they should be paying us. And so the other thing, a number of years ago, some teenagers got up on top of our tanks, cut the locks off, and polluted the tank. We had to drain the tank down and clean it. And I don't think anybody should be on our tanks for any reason except our workers. I'd like to see all those antennas being removed from top of the tanks.
Okay, well, I met with Intellicom today also, so I can brief you, and I'm getting some more documents, and that would probably be the better time to do it.
Okay. If you could put that on your next meeting for a report.
Well, that's in negotiations and everything like that. We can brief you privately and tell you what's going on like that. I'm not ready for a public report on that. We're working through things.
Okay. Any other director's comments? General Counsel update.
I have no further update.
General Manager.
I think we updated a lot talking about the church area and Title 22.
We want to go about supply cars and parking lot.
No. I'm not.
Now you're able to free form, right?
Nope. We will.
Is that something
I told them about you? So
that's it. End of your report?
That's it, yeah. Everything's going good. Staff is working. We've had a lot of leaks, but Brock can tell you about that.
Assistant General Manager.
I have no update.
Smart man.
Director of Finance.
Thank you, Mr. President. Finance staff is working diligently to close the year end books this time. And our auditors are coming next week to inspect our books and the numbers and our reports. Everything, they'll be here for about a week, and then we are hoping to have them issue their report to you the first meeting of November. So we'll keep you posted on that.
Director of Public Works.
No update.
One sec there. All right, without nobody's objection, we'll turn this meeting.